simple relationship is best. Who has an idea as to who they could be? Simple relationship. It could be employee, employer, family member, friend, whatever you want to do. Mother daughter, okay?
So, maybe not.
Mother daughter, okay? All right. And where are you?
At the mall.
In the bathroom.
At the mall.
In the bathroom.
Shopping mall.
Hey, Megan. Okay, they're at the mall.
Megan, you're at that store where we bought these stockings.
In a hosiery store.
No, it was no hosiery store.
Okay, it's like a lingerie type. Okay. Victoria's Secret, and they're shopping for things that you get there. Okay. Why don't you girls come on, and you can be talking as you come on. That would work good. You come into the store, they're talking.
Oh, great. This is so lovely. Look at those. Oh, man, those are so pink.
Oh. I hate coming in here with you, man. You always got to... I was gonna make fun of the stuff I like. I like the thongs and all that, but you won't
be wearing. Well, I don't understand why you just called me mom. It's okay. I guess all the fat things, you can't wear that.
Who's making fun of me just because I'm round?
You're huge.
I'm the fat one. Look at you. You got the rolls in your outside. Saddlebags!
Saddle? Yeah. Like, don't call me a horse.
Yeah.
Well, never mind. Here, oh, look at this purple one.
I don't like that one. It's too stringy.
What? Stringy?
Especially for you.
Shut up.
Are you talking to you? Did I say you could talk?
You're... Shut up.
You got that? No, look at this one over here. I like that dress.
No. No, leave me alone.
Leave me alone.
Why don't you go to the fat department?
There you go, fat department. You gotta go down to the Kmart to get that kind of stuff. Yeah, great.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I'll beat you, fatty.
You go first.
No, because I'll win.
Yeah, right. You just roll there like a fall.
At least I can make it there. I won't pass out like you do.
You'll pass. Yeah.
Yeah.
Shut up.
I don't think we do.
I'm out of here. This sucks.
Okay. You come back here. I'll go home. I hate
you. Once we put him in a place, sometimes it's easier that way. But we have to have a relationship. We have to have a place. And a who, what, and where, basically. You have to have an activity to what we're doing. So, let's put him in a place first. What do you think?
Talk show.
The what?
A talk show.
They're going to be in a talk show. Okay. That would be easy. Then we can have a host. And who do we want to make the host?
Dan.
Yeah. Okay, Dan is the host. And what is the relationship, then, between these two guys? No, we're not going to do that. Let's stay away from specific people and simple relationships.
We'll cut off our federal funding.
They're married to the same woman.
Okay, now this game is explore and heighten, and I have to coach it a little bit. I tell them to explore the different choices, and then to heighten the emotion or the choices. So I'm gonna sit here and try to.
Do we know we're married to the same woman?
Yeah.
You just
found out.
Yeah,
you just found out.
Yeah, let's let Dan do the moderating here. He can choose. Why don't you just introduce yourself to the people.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Bad Julio Show. This is Juan, and this is Lopez. And today they found out they're married to the same woman. So, Nawad, when you heard about this, how did you feel?
Like,
let's not scope this.
Explore your feelings. Explore your feelings.
Well, you know, I wasn't really down with it.
Down? Oh, you know, were you like really down? Was
no,
it sad?
No. No, I was kind of thinking, you know, on a three-way.
Girls, we need to be talking here so we can get our interpreter going.
Until Ben can get his lines right.
There is no point
blah, 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 blah.
No, in the professional stage, this kind of sophomoric behavior would never be tolerated.
Oh, no, here she goes again.
The summer I performed with
the Stratford County Regional Theater. Please, not another one. I was in professional theater stories.
I can't work with him. When will Dr. Stone be back?
Tomorrow.
Fine, we can resume rehearsals then.
But Dr. Stone asked us to keep to the schedule.
We can't rehearse without our director.
Well, it's only for one more night.
I don't think we're going to get anywhere tonight, especially with Beatrice's poor attitude.
That's it. I don't have to take this.
I'm out of here.
What's going on out here?
That sure didn't sound like the opening to a Midsummer Night's Dream.
More like a nightmare with all their bickering.
We're never going to get past Theseus and Hippolytus' first lines.
Hey ho, get wenches and sires, forsooth! What's going on, guys?
Hey, Henry. Oh, hey, wait, I don't think I have you scheduled for today. Are you supposed to be here?
Easy. Just here to work on those lights. Mechanicals don't rehearse until tomorrow, and tomorrow, and tomorrow.
Henry, that's the second time you've quoted that Scottish play.
She's so superstitious.
Come on, you know what you have to do. Go out the door, turn around three times, spit, and swear.
Well, my mother told me never to spit, but I can swear twice instead.
I'm with Tess on this one.
So am I. This play has enough problems without invoking some centuries-old curse.
You can't be serious, Lauren.
The way things are going, can we afford the risk?
Probably not.
Why? What's going on here?
Let's see. We've been here almost an hour. We haven't even made it to Hermia's entrance.
Oh, beastly Beatrice and bombastic Bennett.
Of course, they're in top form today.
Maybe Beatrice is right. Maybe we should just put things on hold until Dr. Stone comes back. It's only one rehearsal.
We're already behind schedule. If we stop rehearsing now, we'll never be ready to open on time.
Why don't we just postpone the opening?
No, can't do. The sets have to be out of here in time for the athletic awards ceremony.
Hey ho, let's hear it for Ron, captain of Junior Fergus, champion soccer team. Woo! Hippolyta, you Amazonian temptress, come away with me. On moonbeams we will fly.
Get away from me. Bottom is supposed to be Titania's lover, at least until she wakes up and sees what you really look like.
Oh, sweet cruelty. Your harsh words draw me to you like a hard-hearted maggot.
How does Helena's line go?
I think it's hard-hearted maggot.
Hard-hearted adamant.
Benny! Ye mighty Duke of Athens.
Hey, Ben, watch this guy. He's trying to steal your Hippolyta.
I propose changing the play. Bottom challenges Theseus and a duel for Hippolyta's hand.
A duel for a hand? Why, that only leaves with one.
What are you doing here?
Saw you slither back into the theater, and I figured I'd better follow you, see what you're up to.
I really hate to interrupt all day, but we should get back to Lucy.
Not without our director.
Well, I was thinking of skipping your section and rehearsing with the Four Lovers instead.
What?
About time.
Yes.
Really? Well, that's fine, I guess. I'll watch. I might be able to help.
Help? Beatrice? That's an oxymoron.
I have performed Shakespeare on the professional stage, you know.
You played a French soldier at the Battle of Agincourt. You had no lines. All you had to do was fall down.
I learned a lot from our director. He once worked with Joseph Papp at the public...
Hey, good night, kid. See you later.
See ya.
Good night, sweet Ben. Have flocks of angels sing thee to thy rest.
Wrong play again.
Hey, don't you still have a curse to take care of?
Henry, did you quote that Scottish play?
I'm afraid so, and now it seems I have this weird fondness for plaid skirts and haggis.
Go now, then get ye gone and rid of your dreadful curse.
I bid you all adieu. Hey, that looks like a loose connection. I'll be in the lighting booth if anybody needs me. Will you join me, Ben?
What, are you coming to park?
All right, now, let's take it from the standard line, How Now, My Love. Hermia's mother has just asked the Duke to put his only daughter to bed. She doesn't marry the man he's chosen as his husband.
That would be Demetrius at your service.
Come on, Demetrius, we're not in this scene.
Those lights okay now?
Fine. Go ahead.
How now, my love? Why is thy cheek so pale? How chance the roses do fade so fast?
Peace! like that. No one will be able to understand the word.
Be like for want of rain, which I could well detain them from the tempest of my eyes.
That means she's crying. She's supposed to be crying.
Ah, me, I could ever only feel my tale of history. The course of true love never did break.
That's one of the most famous lines in the play. It has to stand out more.
But
either it was different in blood.
I don't like this. I cannot take you commenting on every single one of our lines.
Well, I wouldn't have to comment if you did it right.
That's it.
Let's just get through this scene, and then we'll worry about fixing it.
But his choices are all wrong. Really, Rob, you could get so much more out of your lines. Here, let me show you. Oh!
Jennifer! Hey, Jennifer!
Please, Rosalind, we're in the middle of rehearsal.
But I have a memo from the dean. It's about Dr. Stone.
What is it?
What's going on in here? Why did rehearsal stop?
Hey, Dr. Stone's not coming back at all. At least not this semester.
Why not?
Her fellow research ship is taking her out of the country.
What does it say?
They're trying to find another professor to direct Midsummer Night's Dream. In the meantime, we should keep up rehearsals as best we can.
But who's going to direct for now?
Well, it says the stage manager. Take rehearsals until they find a replacement for Dr. Stone.
As a veteran of the professional stage, Beatrice, you should know that when the lead director is not available, that the stage manager must take his place.
That's all well and good in the real theater.
What do you mean, the real theater?
Theater that's not imaginary, I suppose.
I just mean, Jennifer, that you're an adequate stage manager, but you hardly have any directing experience.
Well, this looks like a good chance for her to get some. And do we want to get this play together or not?
We've all worked really hard. I don't want to just throw it all away.
The art students put a lot of time into the sets and props. They're nearly done.
As Varda Vavon said,
all the world's a stage, and the show must go on.
Well, if that's how you feel about it, let's get going.
Just like that? Jennifer's in charge now?
Believe me, I don't like it any more than you do, but it's only going to be one or two more rehearsals. The dean promises to have a new director for us soon.
One or two more rehearsals, Beatrice? You think you can get through all that without blowing your top and commenting us on every single line?
Oh, I can see this. This is going to be fun.
Take charge and tell everybody what to do.
Beatrice does get pretty annoying at rehearsals.
Yeah. I just want you to know, Jennifer, I think you're doing a terrific job, director. Just terrific.
Hi, everybody.
Hi, Jen. Hey, Jen.
All hail, Jennifer.
Henry, not the Scottish play.
Oops, sorry.
Hi. What are you doing here?
We came for the big announcement.
Who's our new director?
I haven't heard anything yet.
The dean promised we'd have a new faculty director by today.
There's not a teacher in the school that wants to direct the Burgess players. It's a thankless job, and actors are such ingrates.
You get no argument from me.
Jenny, oh Jenny, does this mean it's over between us? That you'll never commit to an actor?
No, but I would have an actor committed.
Cha-ching.
Let's get started.
Jennifer, I know the schedule says actors scene one, but I'm getting stout in that scene, and I don't have my lines down yet.
Julia, you only have four.
Never. The cast hasn't had a chance to even look at Act 3. We're all really busy this time of year, you know.
We open in a week. Do you think you'll have your lines by then?
There's no need for sarcasm. We're doing the best we can.
Why don't we run the mechanical scene? I'd like to see how that's coming along.
They're in pretty good shape. I don't think we need to run it again.
One good run-through might help, or
Besides, Beatrice and I are members of the cast, and we are entitled to watch the rehearsal if we want to.
I don't care if they stay, but only one person can direct.
Yeah, why don't we let Jennifer do it, same for the time being. She is the director. Man by man, according to the script.
Here is a scroll of every man's name, who has thought fit through all of Athens to play in the interlude before the Duke and the Duchess on their wedding night, that day.
Cut. That line has to be much more dramatic.
And I'd just like to point out, none of you guys are getting the feel of the poetry.
This part is not written in verse, you moron.
Everybody knows Shakespeare wrote in verse, and don't call Ben a moron.
Fine, idiots. We all know that the commoner spoke in prose.
She's right. You are certainly typecast.
Come on, cut it out.
Look, as long as you two want to be at this rehearsal, I have an idea I'd like to try. Can you make voice noises like cricket sounds or bird calls?
What?
Well, I thought it might add to the scene if the actors that aren't on stage make voice noises. Nothing that will detract from the dialogue, of course. Just enough to add a woodsy atmosphere.
Like this? Go.
Yeah, that's great. Beatrice, you want to try?
I don't sing.
Well, I'm not asking you to sing. Just like make bird noises, like...
Been doing a pretty good job so far.
You can't be serious.
Looks like the only way we can save the show now is if Jennifer directs.
Then that's what we have to do.
Wait a minute. I don't want the responsibility of putting the show up. I never wanted to direct. I was just trying to hold things together until we got a faculty director.
But no faculty member wants a job. You gotta do it.
You can't let us hold 1 week before opening.
It's not my fault. You know, it's not just up to us. It says the tech people and the whole cast has to agree on this.
I don't want to agree with the BB gun over here. I have a problem with it.
Don't call me the BB gun.
But you're always shooting off your mouth.
All I'm saying is I don't want to risk my good name on a potential disaster.
Chekhovian translation. I want to direct and tell everybody what to do.
That's not true. I'm just concerned for my professional reputation.
Unfortunately, Beatrice, we don't have time to assemble a quorum and ship in the UN observers to host the Lord.
If it's a matter of having Jennifer director closing the show, we have to go with Jennifer.
Thanks, Lauren.
I didn't mean to like that.
We all want the same thing. We all want to do this play.
We all want to do it well.
Well, then it's settled. Jennifer will direct, and the show goes up as planned.
Excuse me, I have a say in this too, and I don't think we should make any hasty decisions. And I'm not the only one who has a problem with this. So does Ben.
I don't think it really matters what you think, but I'll tell you the truth.
What's the matter, Beatrice? Are you worried?
No, it's not me. It's not just me.
You know, I think it's getting pretty late, and we all better close down for the night.
Yeah.
I guess we can't do much for the day.
You know, from what continue on with this play. He wants to know. Now.
Come on, better catch him before he leaves tonight.
Let's go,
okay?
Yeah!
Well, I guess rehearsal's over for today.
I think you're doing a great job. Well, you know.
Thanks.
Don't let them get you down. They're just testing your authority. You gotta stand firm.
Well, why do they feel like they have to test me?
I don't know. I guess it's just human nature to test authority. It doesn't matter. How about we go down to Sub and I can buy you a soda?
Thanks, but the whole cast will probably end up down there after they talk to Jean.
I just don't feel like being around any of them.
Won't condemn the whole cast. Some of us are on your side.
I know, and I appreciate it.
Well, how about we go into town? I can buy you dinner.
That almost sounds like a date. Oh. Besides, it wouldn't really be ethical for the director to be seen socially with an actor. People would think I was trying to take advantage of you.
Well, I wouldn't mind.
I'm just tired. I like to be alone for a while and think.
Sure. I understand. I suppose you've lost a lot of sleep over this play. Good nights, parting is such sweet sorrow that I shall say good nights till it be morrow.
That's Julian's line.
She's not using it. She won't mind if I borrow it.
Just as long as you don't quote that Scottish play again. The way things are going, it doesn't seem like you removed those curses from last week.
Oops.
Oops? What do you mean, oops?
Well, I really didn't take any of that stuff seriously if you want to know the truth about it.
Well, I don't either as a rule, but it sure seems like this plays a jinx.
Well, for you, fair lady, I will cross the threshold, turn around thrice, and against my mother's wishes, spit and swear.
Worth a try. But did you know some of those lights on your way out? They're hardly eyes.
Sure.
Thanks, pal. Your prince.
Are you all right, my dear?
1613. Did you know that?
Yes.
Cannon fired in the forming of Henry VIII, hit the roof, and poof, she was gone.
I'm sorry.
Spent my most glorious moments within a hall of bars.
So, you're the great actor Richard Burbage.
The great, illustrious, magnificent, aren't you willing?
So, why are you here?
I can see you're in dire need of my help.
How did you know?
I spend quite a bit of time here. I have observed many of the rehearsals and performances of Will's plays in your diminutive, yet charming arena. You know, not many people remember the name Richard Burbage anymore. I was quite flattered that the Centers of the New World would honor me by lending my name to one of their institutions of higher learning, Burbage Junior College.
Well, I'm sorry to disappoint you, but I'm afraid you've misunderstood.
Misunderstood?
Well, the name of this school is Burgess Junior College, named after Galet Burgess.
Burgess? Not Burbage? Are you sure? Are you very, very sure? I might have known. Few hold dear the memory of poor old Richard Burbage. Remember thee? Aye, thou poor ghost, whilst memory holds a seat in this distracted globe.
Oh, well, you do a very good Hamlet.
I do the definitive Hamlet. I was the first, you know, and the best. Will wrote all the juicy parts for me.
Well, so why are you here? I mean, what's your purpose?
Why, to aid you in your performance. By the looks of your rehearsals, our Lord Schindler's men might not be able to save this fiasco. There was a fine company of actors, if ever there was.
So you're going to save a Midsummer Night's Dream?
I was only human, madam, although I will do my best. See, this particular play is not all that familiar to me, but I will do my best and save it.
Well, we have so many problems, I don't know where to begin.
Let me see this. Yes, this is clever. Quite good. You know, Jennifer, I've never told this to another soul, but I've always wanted to take a stab at one of the clown parts.
Really?
Yes, you tell us to another soul and I will deny it.
No one would believe me if I did.
Oh, yes. Quite funny. That bottom here. Let me play the lion's part too. I will roar, then I'll make the duke say, let him roar again, let him roar again. A quite ridiculous chap. Fitting that Will should write the roar of a pompous actor for Kemp. Oh yes, here's a part that suits me well. Robin Goodfellow. Not as many lines as I would like. Nonetheless, I could do marvels with this Puckfellow.
I wish you could be Puck in our play. At least that would be one actor I wouldn't have to worry about.
Oh, it has been difficult for me.
It's been impossible. The actors won't listen to the director. They won't learn their lines. The bickering is endless. I mean...
Peace and be still. One dilemma at a time. Now, this director business. We did not have directors in my day. Personally, I would not have any use for one.
Well, how did you rehearse?
We had a few members. The most intolerable of which was when the author insisted on taking charge, but I suppose you won't have to concern yourself with that one. The best, I thought, was when the leading actor told everyone what to do. That was best for me.
Well, how did you get them to listen to you?
Confidence, my dear. Absolute confidence.
Well, I don't think I could...
Well, dear, please, you must be bold. Bold and confident, that's the clue. Say it with me. Be bold. I will be bold.
I will be bold.
Say it again. I will be bold.
I will be bold.
Once more!
I'll screw my courage to the stick and play.
I said be bold, my dear, not reckless. Never quote. Nay, do not even paraphrase the Scottish play in a theater. Go take care of it right away. I'll not wait.
Sorry.
America.
How did that whole curse thing with
the Scottish
play starts?
Well, we don't like to talk about it. Although, since the title role is one I originated with unparalleled genius, I will indulge you. Will wrote this one for our Scottish monarch, King James I. On the morning of the play's first performance, the young boy, playing Lady M, fell ill with fever. In my day, ladies did not appear on stage. They were played by young boys.
I've heard that, yeah.
Ladies are great adornments on the stage. Will particularly enjoys hearing them speak his lines. Nevertheless, a poor lad came gravely ill. By noon, he was dead. King James was distressed by all this, and he let us know in certain terms.
So, the curse dates back to the very first performance?
Very unpleasant business. Let us speak of something. Oh, I marvel at how privileged your actors are. Each has a script of his own. In my day, we had to pass one handful of copy from each actor during rehearsal.
Well, how did you learn your lines?
Oh, it's quite easy. See, Will set up his plays sort of as a roadmap. Once you know how to read it, everything else is fine.
So you mean rhyming, alliteration, things like that?
Oh, my dear, that's only a small part of it.
Well, show me.
Turn to any page. Any page, you'll find it. Lysander says, oh, take the sense, sweet of my innocence. Sense and innocence. The repetition of sense not only makes it easier to remember, but it also shows off Lysander's wit.
Well, can you find another one?
Oh, yes, yes. Here, the same passage. Lysander says, but lying so, Hermia, I do not lie. He uses two different meanings of the word lie. And Hermia, in the next line, not only matches Lysander's wit, but he also shows it off.
Now, much pursue my matters in my pride. If Hermia meant to say Lysander lied. But gentle friend, for love and courtesy, lied further off.
That's telling you, Hermia. Now remember, your lies should all be theatrical, conversational, much like your everyday speech.
Well, show me more.
I'm sorry, I haven't any more time. I would like to call it signals my exit.
But I still need your help.
No, you don't. Everything you need, Will Shakespeare has put down here for you. Now remember, be bold and confident. Adieu, Lionel, adieu.
Goodbye. I mean, adieu.
That was weird.
Is that Jenny? Do you think she's been here all night?
I don't know.
Jenny, wake up.
Oh, Henry, what are you doing here? Did you take care of that Scottish business?
Yes, it's done. It's practically been eradicated.
Good.
You know, it's kind of weird, but I kind of have been finding myself taking a hold of that steer superstition. I'm going to go turn some lights on.
Have you been here all night?
I don't know, I guess. What time is it?
It's almost 8 o'clock.
In the morning? I must have dozed off. I had the strangest dream. Well, what are you all doing here?
Cass had a meeting last night.
Yeah, it wasn't planned or anything. We all just ended up down at the student center.
We have to talk about how much hard you've been working on this play.
We decided we needed to make more of an effort, too. We all agreed to come in this morning to get into next year rehearsal time.
Yeah, we left a message on the machine.
Hey, Jennifer's here.
Great, you got our message.
Actually, she's been here all night.
All night? Why?
Well, this close to rehearsal, to opening, rather. A director has a great deal to do. But as long as you're all here to rehearse, we might as well get going. Let's start with Act 3. I hope everybody knows their lines.
I know my lines.
Hey, we're not in Act 3.
Can't we get Oberon to make you disappear?
If we're gonna do this play justice, the bickering has to stop.
Yeah, Beatrice, we don't need any more.
That means everyone. We have to be a team, so let's be a little cooperation. All right, let's take it from the top of Act 3.
And we have another new policy. No actors are admitted to rehearsal unless they're in the scene.
And as Ben mentioned, you're not in Act 3. You can't do this.
Sure, I have
lines.
Well, Shakespeare used word figures to help you remember them.
What do you mean?
Well, here, see your script.
Oh, shoot.
Whatever B and I went down to the mall today and picked it up.
Well, what'd you decide on?
We got her a complete set of works by William Shakespeare.
She'll like that.
She deserves it after everything we put her through.
The audience loves it.
I can't find a Tiny the Fairy.
Settle. I just saw him in the wings.
Well, what about Oberon? I can't find Oberon.
I'll go back there and check on him. Make sure everybody's in their place.
Thanks. I can't believe we made it come back.
The opening of the play was great tonight. You were terrific.
You couldn't have done it without you. It's the best I've ever seen you.
It was working with you. It propelled me to a whole new level.
I hope we can do it again.
I'd really like that.
Oh! Do you think they're just doing this to be in preparation with their role, or are they just pretending?
Maybe we're all just dreaming.
Jenny. Oh, Jenny, you're not going to believe this. Paco's jumping around the dressing room, and well, he did something to his groin. I don't think he's going to be able to finish the play. Poor guy's breathing in pain. I don't think he can get a word out.
Well, somebody has to do the closing speech, even if they just read it.
Why don't you do it?
It's all right, you guys. It's all right.
Have you finished the play?
Oh, no, but there's some guy down there. He says he can do it.
Well, who is he?
I don't know. I've never seen him before, but he fits the costume perfectly.
It can't be happening.
Let's go watch.
If we shadows have offended, think but this and all is mended. That we have but slumbered here, and this weak and idle theme, no more yielding than a dream. Take thy hand if we be friends, and Robin shall restore amends.
I do believe there's magic in this dream.
Escorted by T.J.
It drives me nuts.
Doing any good.
What does that mean? Oh, and you know what? There's a thing to hit steady, and I don't know how to do it. Do you, Travis?
I do. I know. Do I want to say anything?
If you want to, say where you're at. Rosario Beach.
Rosario Beach.
1999.
That's the lady of whoever.
What's in your button tomorrow? Thomas. No.
This is the Rosario Beach Pal.
Please.
It's the sign going down. Okay, good
enough. I'm going down here with that, okay?
This is John Sedgwick's biology class.
Yes.
Come on, Mom.
Just a second. This is Gabriel. Say hi.
Hi.
Tell him about your life.
I don't know you. Okay, can I sing to you?
No, just sing a song.
You do sa 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 with ba 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 with the sun. I'm done.
No, sing one more song.
Do you a sing low? Here do you a sing low? Do do park for the pole.
Okay, good.
Cause sucks. Boat. I don't have a tripod. John's talking to Gabriel about death. Marine base. I'm coming.
That's on film now, right?
Yeah.
can I look at it too?
In a minute.
Sitting there and he's like, well, I don't know anybody yet.